Welcome back, peeps. And for those that are interested in the Twiddler 3, I figured some stuff out that I wanted to talk about today about how to use this device here to control your OBS. So you're going to need a few things first to be able to do this. You're going to need a program from Nutty called Nutty's Official OBS Commander, Noobs Commander. This is actually essentially just a WebSocket integration tool that you can use to write any type of thing inside of OBS, all the different controllers. It's very reminiscent of things like the Touch Portal integrations, Mix It Up integrations, all that type of stuff. The next thing you're going to need is this really weird program called HID Macros. You're going to go into the downloads page, go to version 2.3 and download that. And when you run it for the first time, you're probably going to want to run it as an administrator. And if your OBS is running in admin mode, also run this in admin all the time. So Noobs Commander looks a lot like this right here. It's just simply you got stream record, a bunch of stuff on the left hand side, and then nothing in the middle here. And essentially what you're doing is you're building the actions that you want this thing to be able to do. Now inside of your OBS, I'm going to use the one I'm recording all this in. If you go up to your tools, you will also need the WebSocket plugin. I forgot about that. I'm so used to everyone having it. It's just a download from the official OBS page. It's just like any other plugin install. Once that's there, you want to take a look at what your server port is. And if you have a password, what your password is. Now my server port for this particular OBS is not the standard. It's typically 4444, but because I almost always have two OBSs open, my recording OBS is 4445. So yours will be 4444 usually. Inside of here, the server is almost always the same, but here's the port. This originally starts as 4444. You'll want to change that to whatever your port is and then type in your password if you have one and then click the not connected and that connects you. So what we're going to do is we're going to build up our first action so that I can show you how to use this with HID. I have some 3D effects that are filters that I have already that I already have installed on this particular OBS. So we'll go to filter, show filter, source is on our Canon camera, and it's the filter 3D on. This simply just turns on a 3D transformation thing. And that's it, because all I'm doing is just activating a filter and then it runs. So once you have that, you'll hit export. You'll go to whatever folder you want this to be in, and I'd recommend having a dedicated folder for all of these because there's going to be a lot of them. Name it whatever you would like it to be. I'm going to call mine 3D on and then hit save. And then I want to build one other one. Just because I want to be able to turn this effect on and off, I just simply click the name 3D off. Now I have a whole other one done. Go to export again. I'll call this one very simply 3D off. Now with both of those done, you can see here in the folder, I have this .bat file and a .vbs file. And what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna use this HID macros program to point to these, and I'll explain this. So once your HID macros is up, it'll look something kind of like this. Now you won't have all this stuff on the side here because I've been playing around with the program for a little bit. I essentially built my own kind of stream deck out of just like a $10 wireless numpad that I just bought off of Amazon. But I used this as actually my Premiere Pro editing pad. So I built like certain functions into this, like this is cut, delete, edit, like all the main functions I'm typically using are just right here. So I can have one hand just resting on this thing, typing in whatever I want it to do. And then my other hand just stays on my mouse. And then I can do all sorts of wild keyboard combinations on this thing to just speed up my editing flow. So that's why you see some stuff. But we're not talking about that. We're talking specifically how to control your OBS in the Twiddler 3. If I go to the devices, you'll see actually in here that I already have this Twiddler 3 in here. And that's because as I press buttons on here, you'll see in this device section that different events are triggered. So this is trigger 72. This is trigger 69. Nice. So there's all sorts of triggers that are on side here, and each one of these corresponds to a different button or combination of buttons thereof. So if I want to control those things I just did in Noobs Commander, what I'll do is I'll create a new one. So I'll go to macros, new, and we're going to call this again just 3D on. So this one's called 3D on, and then I'm going to scan trigger. And this trigger I want to do is just this A key, or if you have any other keyboard, it's just whatever keyboard that's on that thing. So I'll click the A button, boop. And now we see here that we have Twiddler 3 65A. Once you have it, go down to run application, go ahead and click the three dots to find your program and navigate to wherever you have your, like the Noobs Commander stuff that we just did. Now, because this is 3D on, I'm gonna do 3D on VBS, hit open. Now that one's running that one. So before I show this, let's go ahead and make the off one. So we'll do new, we'll call this one 3D off. I'll pick up my Twiddler 3 and I'm just gonna make the next one the B key. So I'll hit scan B. You can see here again, right? 66B, whereas this one was 65A. Again, run application, three dots, and then 3D off VBS. BS. So now I have these two different things that are running. We're going to show how this works. So both hands right here. So I'll hit A. And now I'm certainly a chunker boy. Or I'll hit B. And now I'm back to normal. So using just this, right? So both hands are up here. I can go back and forth between whatever type of filters or triggers that I have set up inside of Noobs Commander, and you can use Noobs Commander to run literally pretty much anything. I haven't messed around enough yet with Noobs Commander to see what you can't do with it, but from what I have seen, you should be able to do most of everything you would normally do inside of like Touch Portal, Mix It Up, or otherwise. And then you can just simply use Mix It Up to trigger these VBS files or the .bat files, whatever one works for those particular programs. So you can just use this with nothing else. So imagine, right, you're doing something and you're like, oh, funny joke. Bam, you hit a button and like laughter plays or something. So, or you can have scene transitions or things pop up on screen. You can use this to trigger all sorts of stuff, and there's 111 combinations. I don't know the exact number, but it's a lot of combinations you can use. You have a lot of ability to do a lot of things. So people like Sushi Dragon, right, has two of these. So it's like over 200 different things that Sushi Dragon can trigger at any given time based off of what they've selected. I don't know if they use Noobs Commander. I don't know how they have stuff set up, but I'm just saying that this is one way that I know you can set it up to trigger a whole lot of stuff. If you have any questions, let me know down below. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. Love ya. Bye.